See the crossbar that's lodged into the vase, and then the water line is lifted up, and then I have my two main branches interlocking with one another. I bought this beautiful bunch of mixed colors from Costco today. They very rarely have mixed colors in their lily bunches, so I have to decide if I want to go with the deep red or the orange. For these soft stem flowers and materials, you cut them in water to help keep them fresh. And this one again, here's my triangle. This one's coming out to the front in my direction. So those are the main stems. That's the structure now. From here, I can fill in. And that will be just what you like with the eyes. I have a few viburnum branches. We still have some color in late November. More into the browns and golds that still look good in the garden. Decided to cut the lilies and move one back because they were exactly the same length. So we have another triangle here, which gives us visually a little bit more interest. So now I'm going to fill in. I have two types of viburnum leaves. These branches now are forming a structure inside the vase, where they can help to hold one another. Now I could stop right here. This would be enough for the basic arrangement. But I would like to fill in a little bit more with some of this color. Stop here. So I took one branch of the lilies and then split it so that I could get different lengths of lily, different openings. And then I took one of the buds, a small bud, and placed it in here as well, coming forward on the lowest portion. And then I have two types of viburnum leaves filling in through here and into the back. So that's your basic arrangement, slanting variation. I'm going to do a freestyle arrangement in this tall vase, which is rapidly becoming one of my favorite vases. It's been sitting around the house with dried things in it, and I hadn't even thought of arranging it. And the inspiration for this freestyle is this piece of grapevine that I cut. And I don't really have a plan. I'm just going to see where I go with the vase and the materials that I have. So we'll just start with the grapevine and taking a look at it. It actually looks beautiful from either side. But many of these branches are growing towards me, so that's the side I'll use. And I'm just going to see if the vase will hold things for me. So far, so good. Following any particular rules here and doing freestyle, whatever you like. Now, I just did a basic arrangement following the rules of Ikebana, and I used some of these weeping beech branches, which are beautiful. And you can see that the leaves have already frozen. It's almost December. but they still have beauty as they curl. They have a beautiful subtle green color with some brown. So I'm going to use a couple of those branches. All right, so I'm happy with the basic structure. The lilies are from a Costco bunch that I picked up today. Now, what I don't particularly like in designing here is to have two flowers coming out at almost exactly the same length, so one of them has to go. Move my lilies around a little bit. My first thought was to have them all low, but I've decided to go with a little bit higher and move my reds on the diagonal here. And now we'll be filling in with some other elements. Different types of viburnums that still had some colored leaves. It's very late in the season, but they are still beautiful. That I might like to use some grapes. So we'll just see how that works out. And last weekend was Thanksgiving, so we're decorating now. So I have some hooks for Christmas ornaments. I have the grapes now hanging on the grapevine, and then a piece over here on the beach. And I still need some leafing material in the front.